Should we start or do we wait for a few more minutes?
Few more minutes, okay.
Yeah, I think just a few more minutes. Two more minutes. People are coming in. I think just.
Your one drop of the cloud can create. Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning.
Happy Environmental Day, ma'am.
Happy World Environment Day to everyone present here.
Good morning, ma'am.
The nature crown myself. I am going to coronate the nature.
Good morning, ma'am.
All right.
I just wanted to give this about the tree
world environment. Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, ma'am.
Wow, Shreya is showing something that she has made. Plant a tree, it says. Great.
Wow.
Morning, ma'am.
Good morning. Thank you for joining us.
Good morning, ma'am. This is I made this one, ma'am, with the waste. Paper plates and
using waste. Okay. That's wonderful, Shreya. Wonderful.
Thank you.
Tushita, let's start.
All right. So now we officially begin.
Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning to all.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, ma'am. Good morning,
ma'am. So Kanya, now I think we can put everyone on mute and then I can start.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, ma'am.
A very warm welcome to all of you present here. First of all, happy World Environment Day. We are together here on this occasion of World Environment Day for something very special. And I think most of you know here what that is about. But for all our students present here, what do you think this is about? Are we going to discuss something entirely new? Or do you think we are going to talk about something we have already talked about? So if you think this is about something entirely new, you can give me a thumbs up using the reactions. You can see the reactions option in the bar below. You can use that option and tell me if you think this is going to be something new or something we've already talked about. So what do you think this is going to be? Okay, I can see some thumbs up. Let me go to the next screen. Something new. All right. Something new. Keshav, what do you think? You can use a thumbs up or a thumbs down to tell me. If you think this is something new that we're going to be talking about, give me a thumbs up. If not, maybe a thumbs down. Thumbs up. All right. Okay. There are a lot of thumbs up. Yes. So we are going to be talking about something entirely new this World Environment Day. We will launch our website for young environmentalists like you. And this is the first time we are launching it. So you will be the first ones to witness it and visit it. So it's entirely new. All thumbs up. And I think we can now start. Thank you, all of you, for being here with us. I know these are difficult times. All of us are stressed. We are managing online somehow with our classes, schools, and everything. But you took out time for this, and you showed all this excitement here. So it really makes all of us happy. My colleagues are here from CSE. Sunita ma'am and Rustam sir are also already here. So by welcoming them, we start today's event. I will ask Anubhuti, who's a senior reporter and sub-editor with us, to formally commence the program. She's also played a pivotal role in making this website happen that we're going to be launching in some time. So Anubhuti, over to you.
Thank you so much, Tushita. Hello, everyone. A very warm welcome to Rustam ji, to Sunita ma'am, our old-time Gopher Times colleagues, my CSC team, teachers, friends from different educational institutes and other organizations who have joined us. And a very warm welcome to all our loving children who are here with us. Today, we are here to launch the Young Environmentalist website, which has been an effort of several months. But in reality, the story is a little is far older. The website actually attempts to digitize Gopa Times. The first edition of it was actually launched in May-June 1992. So therefore, today it's the 30th birthday of Gopa Times, and on the eve of World Environment Day, I'm very glad that we are relaunching the magazine in a new avatar. I hope that you all love it and enjoy the host of bustling activities and updates we are going to offer on the Young Environmentalist. I would request Tushita to take over and continue with the rest of the program.
Thank you, Anubhuti, for that introduction and welcome. We have a lot of people from diverse backgrounds here. We have teachers, a lot of familiar faces, students, and many new faces as well, which is great to see. We have people from NGOs, different government organizations. We welcome all of you. And now we will delve deeper into how this website came into being. So I think a few months ago, this website was only an idea in our heads. And then under Sunita ma'am's direction, she ensured that we see it through and we make this website happen. And so I think she's the best person right now to give us a brief introduction on the journey of this website that we have had. Origins mostly, you know, tell very real stories. So we would like to hear one such real story from Sunita ma'am. So over to you, ma'am.
Thank you, Tushita. And firstly, let me thank everybody who's here. I mean, you know, World Environment Day is such an important day for all of us because it's a day that makes us recommit ourselves to a clean environment. But today, hearing all of you, hearing Happy World Environment Day, Happy World Environment Day, gives me so much energy. And I think I can say the same for all my colleagues. It really gives us energy to take forward the work, to want to do more. And I want us all to work together. So thank you so much for being there. Each one of your faces is giving me so much pleasure today. So thank you. Thank you so much. I'm also very happy to be with my colleagues here because most important has, you know, it's been a long journey. And I can see Shumita Dasgupta here, who has been a long-term time colleague who worked on children's our education program and a very dear colleague and remains a dear colleague. Chitra is here. Chitra worked with us for many years, and again, so important for us to reconnect. So I'm so happy that we have found an opportunity to come together on this. And of course, there is Rustam. Anubhuti, it's 30 years of Down to Earth this year. And actually, in May 1992, I remember distinctly, Rustam had joined us to start working as the art head at Down to Earth. And Anil Agarwal, who was our editor, our mentor, all of us, many of us knew him. I remember he and Rustam going through this huge exercise of determining what would be the cover page of Down to Earth. And the entire effort in Rustam's first painting, which we have reused this time in Down to Earth, in which he talked about this enormous, you know, exuberance of every part of the world. And he talked about how we could actually greenwash all of it. We needed to walk the talk. And that sense is what Rustam said in 1992, May of 1992, is something that we are talking about with even greater urgency today. Walk the talk, walk the talk. Don't just talk the talk. And that's where I think, you know, Down to Earth, and then of course, Gopa Times. And the very word Gopa Times, and I hope Rustam will talk a little bit about why Gopa, because today we have forgotten the reason why we called it COVID times. And we need to understand it once again and to see that in our own understanding of why Gobar is so important as an environmentalist. What does Gobar bring to us? Why is cow dung? Cow dung is seen to be, and I remember the first thing about cow dung, which all of us, you know, we're urban, we live in urban areas. Humne kab dekha hai cow dung? जब कभी गांव जाते हैं तब कुछ देखते हैं, बाकी का कब देखते हैं। मगर कितना इम्पोर्टेंट काउडंग है एनवायरनमेंट के लिए, वो एक चीज समझने की जरूरत है। दैट इज व्हाई आई थिंक वी नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड द रेलेवेंस ऑफ द वर्ड एंड व्हाई वी कॉल्ड इट कोबर टाइम्स। बट एंड आई विल लीव इट टू रुस्तम टू एक्सप्लेन दैट टू ऑल ऑफ अस बिकॉज ही डज इट सो ब्यूटिफुली। But I just want to thank and to say how much this journey has meant and how important this work has been. When we started our work, Anubhuti, as you asked me to do, to talk about this, and Tushita, one thing we were clear about is that we wanted environmental education, and I can see all the young faces with us, we wanted it to be meaningful. We wanted it to be not just about learning, but also doing. And that is why the entire effort that was made to create what we call today the Green Schools brand, which is schools that sign up to walk the talk, that you do an audit of what you do, how environmentally friendly you are, what do you actually end up doing in terms of your waste management, your water management, how much rainwater do you harvest, how much more can you harvest, how much waste do you generate, how much plastic do you bring into the school, can you get rid of the plastic you bring into the school, can you segregate your waste, how do you compost your waste. All that are steps towards that green world that we need. Today in World Environment Day, what is very important for us to take that pledge to say we will walk the talk, because things are bad. We are seeing today climate change happening in the world around us. We know today that climate change will bring more weird weather. I mean, all of us see rain, but rain, when it comes with this extreme force, it creates floods and it destroys people's homes. And that is what we will see more and more with climate change. So we need to make sure that we can walk the talk. We have to be able to do much more to make our world greener and cleaner. And that is why your effort, each one of you, I mean, to join us, to be part of this journey, and to take this forward is so important, gives me all the strength and the courage to go on. And I think it is really important today to see how we can use, how each one of you can be part of this website that we have done, Young Environmentalist. When we named it Young Environmentalist, and my colleague Saurith is here, and Ranjita here, we thought about it. And you know, Gandhiji, when he came to this country, talked about young India. And we really need to talk about young environmentalists today. It's not to say, you know, we are asking you to get onto the streets and to do a dharna, but we are asking you to understand what environment means in our lives so that we can all be better. And we can practice the change. We can be the change. That's what Gandhiji talked about. That's what our effort will be, to work with you, to see what can we do so that we can actually do things differently. So once again, thank you so much for joining us on this journey. And thank you particularly Shumita, Chitra, Ranjita, Saurith, Tushita, Neeraj, Anubhuti, who have made this happen. And of course, Suparno Banerjee. Suparno is now leading our work on environmental education. And he takes on one more responsibility. He's already got a lot on his plate at CSC. But I think his understanding of the issue, and more than that, his desire to make sure that he works with all of you, I think will make sure that we can all work together and make that difference. So thank you again for joining us today. And I'm looking forward to the launch of the website.
Thank you, Sunita ma'am, for that trip down the memory lane. And definitely walking the talk has always been one of the biggest values here at CSE for us, be it our school program, our program for households, that always drives us. So we will now head towards launching of the website. So are you all present here ready? Are we ready to do that? I know you cannot unmute yourself, but can you give me a thumbs up? Can we go into that direction? All right, great. So before we officially launch it, a big kudos to Sorit Gupto and Anubhuti, who are both present here. They have put the magazine Gober Times together, which we are going to be launching along with the website. It's placed on our website. We'll give you a look in just a while. So now to launch this website along with Sunita ma'am, I invite Rustam Vanya. Rustam is the Academic Dean at Srishti School of Art, Design and Technology in Bangalore, Karnataka. And I would like to share a few lines about Rustam before we begin. He's here today as an old and valued friend of CSE. He was one of the originators of and also one of the brains behind Gober Times, a cartoonist, illustrator, and a design guru. CSE publications continue to be inspired by his work, and we continue to use his work because it's so relevant and impactful even today. So a big welcome to Rustam sir, and I invite you to now launch the website and sort it. I will share my screen so that everyone can see. All right, so in one click, we are going to unveil the website that we have designed for environmentalists like you and teachers like you to be used as a resource. So here we go.
Rustam will do the unveiling.
Okay. Good morning, everyone. And thank you so much for having me. It's a real pleasure to be, especially with young people and so many of you with the kind of energy and enthusiasm you have. I'm suddenly feeling the same age which I was when Gober Time started. So on this very special occasion, I would like to first, before I say anything about reminiscing, I would like to formally launch the Young Environmentalist website, which CSE is the best institution to do that. And I'm sure it's going to play a very major role in the future in inspiring more and more young environmentalists like you all who are here in doing some serious work besides having fun along the way. So I congratulate CSE on this excellent effort and much needed actually. I think we do need a space where there is well written and well presented information. We live in a world of misinformation today. It wasn't like that 30, 40 years ago. And it's amazing how much misinformation we deal with. So in a very credible space like CSE, Down to Earth and Gober Times, I think it's an excellent initiative. So, okay, after congratulating all of you and all the other team members who probably were behind such a big effort, thank you so much. And I think the world will be a better place for this website. So,
can we also take 1 minute to see Gober Times?
Yes.
New avatar.
I think it's always great to see things evolve, change, and move on. As they say, the show must go on. And I think that's one of the biggest achievements of CSE and Down to Earth, that for so many years, so consistently, it has been delivering very good, credible information for popular consumption, not just for experts. And I think I really appreciate that consistency.
So this magazine now is, and we'd like to thank particularly once again, Rustam Sorit, who has taken on a very formidable challenge of turning the magazine into digital, as well as Anubhuti. And this will now be available to everyone to be able to read, to be able to download. So it is a monthly publication, Gobar Times, and it will be available to everybody. So I'm really excited that we have been able to do this. And again, thank you, Saurith. Thank you, Anubhuti. And thank you, Shuparno.
So let's go down a bit down memory lane. You know, when before we even came up with the idea and started producing a magazine for children, I remember one very late evening in, there was no building at that time in Tughlakabad. We used to function out of a small space in east of Kailash. I think E6, was that right?
Yes.
And it's a small place, many people working, very busy, a lot of energy in the space, but very tiny. And all of us used to, even to pass by, we had to sort of give way to each other in the corridor because it's so not wide enough. So there were a lot of pictures which Anilji and Sunita were going through. And I was trying to help them edit and choose pictures and things. And then suddenly Anilji stopped and he said, "This encapsulates the values of India." It was as if he was talking to himself. So then all of us were really curious, what is he saying? He was looking at something, and he was looking at a slide. In those days, there were used to be these slides, which used to be the pictures. It was just one slide, if you had to look after it, otherwise fungus would come and eat it away. So then we all looked at the picture. It was one cow dung cake lying on the ground, fresh. And in the middle of it, there was a stone.
Yes.
So I said, "So this picture, what do you think? It's a gopar, it's a patthar pada hua hai. Isme kya badi baat hai?" So he's saying, "No, this picture is when we went to Rajasthan and we were curious ourselves, ki isme har gopar ke us pat mein jaake dekhte hain ki ek patthar pada hua hai. Aage gaye to ek aur patthar pada hua hai." So he said, then we asked someone, some local person, ki ye patthar kyun hai iske andar? So ye patthar maane ye kisi ne le liya hai. माने ये मेरा है, आप उसको छू नहीं सकते हो. इसका माने वो गोबर का बहुत वैल्यू है. दे वॉन्ट टू से दैट दिस इज अ समवन हैज ऑलरेडी आइडेंटिफाइड दिस फॉर देमसेल्फ बिकॉज काउ इज रोमिंग अराउंड एवरीवेयर एंड इज लीविंग बिहाइंड गोबर पैट्स एवरीवेयर. सो देन ही सेड, या दिस इज हाउ वी वैल्यू अ वेस्ट एज अ रिसोर्स. नाउ दिस विल बिकम ऑन द वॉल्स, इट विल बिकम ऑन द फ्लोर, इट विल बिकम फ्यूल, इट विल बिकम एनर्जी. It will be used in all sorts of purposes and recycled and reused. And that was, I remember that moment. And then later, one day, many years, not many years, say 3 or 4 years later, and we started, and then I'm talking about mid-90s. My God, I even forget when Gobar Times started. Shumita, do you remember?
Mid-90s. I think 1998, if I remember right. Somewhere around that time. Long time.
Then he just one day randomly calls me into the office and he says, "Can you produce something for younger audiences?" That was the only brief. I said, "What?" "I don't know." So I said, "Yeah, but tell me what you want. That's for you to figure out." And I think that was one of his greatest strengths. He never said, "Ki aap ye karo, aise karo, waise karo." Aapko kuch, I'm giving you this task. Now you should be up to the challenge. And then we did all kinds of experiments. We tried out. So there was a Pioneer, a newspaper, it was finished, it doesn't exist anymore. It was a fair, education fair. So there was a colleague of mine, Pratap, who wrote good, he was very good at writing. It takes time to write it, but he writes good. So then he produced this and we said, we went to Anil Ji, what should we call this? We are trying out something, you said, try out for young thing. So he's saying, "You know, to tell you the truth, when I started Down to Earth, I wanted to call it Gobar Times." So I said, "You wanted to call Down to Earth Gobar Times?" He said, "Yeah, the people didn't take me seriously. But it's a serious message." He's saying, "It is a serious message. This is the LPG of India. This is the fuel of India. This is the most rural Indian survive on it. And it's a waste. And they make good use of it. And I want that value in society." So he said, "Okay, you use this name." So I would give him credit for having given that name. And then we produced and we made a masthead and we made one dummy copy and we went to this Pioneer Fair. It was a big hit. It was just a pamphlet. It was just 2 folds of A4, 4 pages, that's all. But there were all children coming and taking. And then one thing we also realized in the production of Global Times, कि वो बोलते ना ये बच्चों के लिए है. हमने धीरे धीरे नोटिस किया कि सब एडल्ट आके नहीं उठा के पढ़ रहे हैं इसको. तो फिर हमने देखा अच्छा ये तो सबको इंटरेस्ट है इसमें. बच्चों को भी इंटरेस्ट है, एडल्ट को भी इंटरेस्ट है. हमने सोचा क्यों इनको इंटरेस्ट है इतना, क्योंकि उसकी जो पैकेजिंग है वो उसको अगर आप बिटर पिल माने आप बोल रहे हो कि सारा डूम एंड ग्लूम है और एनवायरनमेंट खराब हो रहा है ये वो, लेकिन उसको अगर आप एक इंटरेस्टिंग वे में ह्यूमर के साथ पैकेज करके तो बहुत ज़्यादा लोग उसमें इंटरेस्ट दिखाते हैं. आई थिंक दैट वॉज वन ऑफ द सक्सेसेस ऑफ दैट काइंड ऑफ पैकेजिंग एंड कम्युनिकेशन. एंड देन आई ऑल्सो फाउंड आउट दैट स्टॉप मेकिंग अ डिस्टिंक्शन बिटवीन चिल्ड्रन एंड एडल्ट्स, सॉर्ट ऑफ एवरीवन इज एन ऑडियंस. एंड आई थिंक दैट वॉज वेरी नाइस. एंड then COVID time started, and then after that, after I left, Shunita took over and did a wonderful job. Sorit and team and Anubhuti and others are there, and most importantly, all of you who are listening, you are there. You are the ones who are going to be the young environmentalists, and if the future has to change, you are the ones who are going to help do it. We are there to support you, and we are always there to give the experience of what we've had from the past, and we have to hand over this baton now to all the young people over here. So thank you so much, and it's a great occasion, and congratulations to CSE and Dr.
Rishita. If I may get a minute, just I want to welcome Ashish. Ashish is here as well. Ashish also worked with Gobar Times and helped to build everything that we have done. So I just want to make sure that Ashish, I can see his face. Thank you for joining, Ashish.
Also, and Pranay is here, Sunita ji.
Pranay is here? Really? Yes. Okay, I can't see him. So there's so many faces, but but welcome, Pranay. Thank you for joining as well. So happy to see everyone's face. And I think, jo, you know, Rustam ne kaha, wohi sabse jaruri cheez hai ki hum recycling ki baat karte hain, aur hum sochte hain ki humne seekha hai recycling. मगर जो जब अनिल ने इस पूरी चीज को गोबर टाइम्स बुलाया था तो उनके दिमाग में यह था कि देखिए हमारे देश में रिसाइकलिंग होती है और हम जिस चीज को वेस्ट मानते हैं, हम सोचते हैं कि ये तो बहुत गंदी चीज है, ये तो फेंकी जाती है, उसी चीज लेके लोग इस्तेमाल करते हैं. और वही आज की जो सीख है, आज के बारे में जो हम बात करते हैं कि हम एनवायरमेंटलिस्ट हैं क्योंकि हम रिसाइकलिंग करते हैं, क्योंकि हम कम इस्तेमाल करते हैं, क्योंकि हम ध्यान से इस्तेमाल करते हैं. यही जो समझ है वो गोबर टाइम्स का जो पूरा गोबर, क्यों हमने इसको बुलाया, क्यों ऐसी चीज के बारे में हमने पूरा मैगजीन का नाम दे दिया. मुझे लगता है जो रुस्तम ने अभी समझाया मुझे बहुत याद आ रही थी. थैंक यू रुस्तम. आई हैड फॉरगॉटन दैट टेल अबाउट द गोबर एंड द स्टिक इन इट एंड द स्टोन इन इट, एंड आई वाज देयर विद अनिल व्हेन वी टुक दैट पिक्चर. इट्स रियली ब्रिंगिंग बैक मेमोरीज. सो थैंक यू सो मच. सो थैंक यू तुषिता, थैंक यू फॉर लेटिंग मी इंटरवीन. थैंक यू.
श्योर. वी हैव एकलव्य आल्सो. सो
एकलव्य इज देयर एज़ वेल.
यस यस.
हाय एकलव्य, थैंक यू फॉर जॉइनिंग. सो हैप्पी टू सी यू एज़ वेल. थैंक यू. थैंक यू.
I would also extend a very warm welcome to all the friends of CSE who are now joining us. And I wasn't here at that time at CSE, but thank you, Rustam, for letting us in on all those memories. We now feel closer to GP after having heard those stories from you. And now that the website has officially been launched, I would like all of you to take a look at it, see what's there for you, and check out different things. So as you can see on the Zoom screen, we have young environmentalist. The inspiration for the name comes from all of you, from all the activities that you were sharing in the beginning of this call, all the things that you do, no matter how small they are for the environment, they all matter, they all count, and you are all young environmentalists, and this is a website for you. So keep coming back to it, because the idea is to keep adding things here that excite you, that educate you, and that prod you to take an action. So on this screen, you can see we have divided our website into sections. We have air and mobility, water, climate change, waste, food, energy, biodiversity, and everything else. So we like to call it etc. These sections include stories, games, DIYs, cartoons, videos, activity sheets, and a lot more. This is a recurring thing. We will keep adding material to it. So if I could just show you a small glimpse of a game. We don't want environment education to be monotonous. You know, that is the last thing we want for our young environmentalists. It can be fun as well. And you have taught us that. And this website is our way of showing everybody that this can be fun too. And you can learn a lot of things while having fun. So let's look at this waste game and how we can play it. This is a board game that in fact teaches us about different types of waste and what green practices we can adopt with regard to those types of waste. So you roll the dice here on the screen and your ninja avatar moves on the screen. A card pops up that you have to answer. All right, so my ninja avatar has landed on a green box and I've got a green card here, which says Chiku gets the waste badly dumped in front of his house removed. So Chiku gets the waste removed. Is this a green practice? That's what I have to tell now. Okay, so do young environmentalists know here if this is a green practice or not? Give me a thumbs up if this is a green practice. And I'll click on yes if I get a lot of thumbs up. If I get thumbs down, I'll click on no. Sukanya, can you help me know which reaction we are getting from most people present here? I will respond according to you. If you give me a thumbs up, I'll click on yes. If you give me a thumbs down, I'll click on no, and we'll see if this is the correct answer. So what do we have here, Sukanya? I am not able to see my Zoom screen.
Need more responses.
Sorry?
We need more reactions.
All right. Okay, give me a thumbs up if you want me to click on yes. Yes, it's a green practice that Chiku does. And give me a thumbs down if you want me to click on no. This is not a good practice if Chiku gets the waste removed.
We have no thumbs up, so I think we can go ahead with that.
All right. So trusting all my young environmentalists present here, I'm going to click on yes and see what happens. All right. It's the right answer. It is a green practice. And I've got one gain because of people here for giving me the correct answer. And this is how you can progress. So with this game, we can learn a bit about waste. And similarly, for all sections, you can check out all the different types of categories that we have and learn new things about these. I will now stop sharing and we can now move to the next section of the program. Which is the highlight because young environmentalists like you get to speak in that section. So whenever we start anything new, be it a home audit or a school audit, something that drives us and helps us remain relevant is feedback from our multipliers, which are our teachers, and our interactions with students. We heavily rely on what you tell us about our products and what we're offering and the kind of programs we design for you. And this website is no different. So we have invited students and teachers from our network schools to assess our website, tell us how they can use it, how students and teachers can use it, what they liked about the website and what their wish list is. Wish list is something that they want us to include in the future. And I think that is the best way to proceed about this website. So we can officially start our next section now. The first school which is going to be sharing is Global Public School from Ernakulam, Kerala. We have the coordinator of the school, Susanna ma'am, and the student ambassador for the section on air and mobility, Anne Maria Felix from grade 12. So I would request Sukanya to first unmute Anne. And after Anne is done, we can listen to Susanna ma'am.
Good morning, respected dignitaries, teachers, the Green School Program team, and my fellow students. In a world where paradoxically, breathing itself has become harmful to our health, it is incredibly essential for us to understand the severity of the situation our Mother Earth is in. Through the videos that raise our awareness on air pollution, to the posters and cartoons, everything under the section of air and mobility, draws our attention to air pollution and makes us actively search for ways in which we can reduce the drastic and dreadfully overwhelming statistic of 600,000 children dying each year due to deadly air infections. Although the global pandemic makes our future look grim at the moment, we as students have proven time and time again that given the right guidance, we are capable of facing any adversity. That is why I am 100% confident that we will be able to use the website with its do-it-yourself activities, worksheets, quizzes, everything will make us raise our awareness so that we may be able to spread our newfound knowledge to our friends, peers, families, everyone, so that we can save our Mother Earth before the situation gets out of control. While eco-friendliness has always been at the forefront of global public schools since the beginning, I'm sure that the tips provided in the website will make the environment the priority in all of our lives. From the minute I looked into the website, the videos were what caught my eye, especially the video stating that breathing was injurious to health. I was mortified. I didn't know how we could make our beautiful Earth into such a horrible place at the moment. So I started reading and researching on how we can prevent this from happening again. And my only suggestion that I would like to request be put into order is that a specific part of the website be dedicated for senior students like myself, so that we would be able to put in our contributions, be it a small story or a personal anecdote about how we are doing our part to save the environment. I am confident that this initiative will truly motivate many more young environmentalists to make this world a better place. After all, in the wise words of Mr. Lester Brown, we have not inherited the world from our forefathers. We have borrowed it from our children. Thank you.
Thank you, Anne. Very aptly put. And that's definitely one of the things that we plan to do in the future, invite entries from students like yourself and showcase on the website. So thank you for your sharing of the section. We will now move to Susanna, ma'am. Susanna, ma'am, I invite you to speak on the website overall and give us a teacher's point of view on this. If Susanna, ma'am, could be unmuted, please. All right, maybe there's some issue at present because weather is not that good in Kerala. We've been. Okay, are you there?
Yeah, we can.
Yeah, please go ahead, ma'am. Susanna, ma'am?
Susanna, we can't hear you. No.
All right, we will circle back to Susanna, ma'am, then. Probably a network issue there. We will move to our next school and our next student ambassador who will, there are actually two student ambassadors for the section on energy on our website. You can see the section right here. We have Man Upadhyay and Vani Kataria from MRA DAV Public School Solan in Himachal Pradesh. They are both in grade 10 and we have also done extensive work in Himachal Pradesh with regard to energy. And so now we will invite Man Upadhyay first to tell us about the energy section, what he thinks of it, and what more he would like to be included on the website. So Man, please go ahead.
Yes, ma'am. So first of all, thank you for providing me this apple and happy 30 years of anniversary on this Goba Times. Now I would like to begin with my speech. So the proper use of science is nature, but to live in it. Good morning, everyone. Today, I'm Man Upadhyay from MRADAV Public School Solan, Himachal Pradesh, is very excited to talk about the energy section of the glorious website developed by Down to Earth organization. Clicking on this one link opens several doors and provides us with a variety of information and images, which establishes our visual interaction and also maintains our interest. The page starts with the story of which we can easily relate to with our day-to-day life. The part of solar revolution is one of the best as it contains variety of facts and variety of figures. The site also has stories, posters, DIYs, activities, games, videos, cartoons, magazines, calendars, etc., which are very engaging. But the fun element of website is the game section, because children will not only use it for the purpose of entertainment, but unknowingly they will also learn a lot about environment, due to which they will become a productive output for the future society. The Gobar Gyan magazine also has wide variety of resources which the students can use to enhance their society into better and greener place. I would wish to suggest that information regarding the nuclear energy should be given a rightful place. At last, but not the least, each and every student should use this website so that more and more awareness related to environment is spread, and also our world turns into an even more better place to live. Thank you. Happy Environment Day. Now I would like Vani Kataria to speak some words about this website.
All right, Vani, please go ahead. Thank you, Man.
Like music and art, love for nature is a common language that we all share, irrespective of our social or political boundaries. Good morning, one and all present here. I'm Vani Kataria from Class 10, MRA DAV Public School, Solan, Himachal Pradesh. Today, I feel overwhelmed to speak about the Young Environmentalist website on this auspicious occasion of Environment Day. We all were introduced to science and social studies together by the name of environmental studies in our grade 1. Until date, we all have studied many chapters related to sustainable development, conservation of resources, waste management, and forms of energy. But when we were in our lower grades, our books used to be animative. They enhanced the imagination of students. But as we moved to our higher grades, our books became textual. They just comprised of data, facts and figures which bounded the imagination of students. On the contrary, Young Environmentalist website had it all. There were interesting videos, facts, games, stories, DIYs, which grabbed my attention at once. The introductory story given in the energy section was very relatable. And the best part of the website was the scientific approach given for each DIY and experiment. My favorite portion was the solar revolution one, which was very informative and interesting at the same time. As I'm a visual learner, the games, videos, animations hooked me to the website. I would also like to see the use of charts, graphs, and tables, which will make the analysis of data easier. Also, if a few case study questions will be included, it will make the outcome more productive as students will learn how to implement green ideas in their day-to-day lives. And a special thanks to CSE, Gobar Times, Down to Earth, and Tushita ma'am for giving us an opportunity to represent our school on this website launch. Thank you.
Wonderful. Thank you so much, Mani, Vani and Man. Your wish list has duly been noted. And there are some great ideas there. And thank you for reminding us that there's something in this website for everyone. If you're a visual learner, there's something for you as well. If you like to read stories, you can go through the plethora of stories that we have here. If not, you can watch videos. You can try out DIYs if you're more of an experiential learner. So do check out the website and all the different activities that we have here and see which one clicks the most for you. Moving ahead, and thank you Charu ma'am and Urvashi ma'am for supporting me with this entire thing for MRA DAV Public School. They're present here in the event, so a big thank you to them. Moving to our next school, our next student ambassador is for the waste section on the website. Yesha Modi is from grade 9, Shiv Nadar School, Noida. And after Yesha, we will have Ashu Ratra ma'am from the same school, Shiv Nadar, Noida, to give us her perspective on the website as a teacher. So we will begin with Yesha.
Thank you, ma'am. Recycle it all, no matter how small. Good morning, everyone. I am Yesha Modi from grade 9, Shiv Nadar School. Warm greetings to everyone present here and regards to Sunita ma'am, Anubhuti ma'am, and Rustam sir. Wish you all a very happy World Environment Day. It is my privilege to be here and share my views on the waste section of a very interactive website, the Young Environmentalist. I often think and try to understand, what is waste all about? Waste is what I see daily in my society and home over the last few months. Tons of masks, PPE kits, gloves, and home essentials after use are thrown daily by residents. Waste is an item that no longer has a use and purpose and needs to be disposed of with care. So, is it right to get rid of everything that we use? To answer this, waste management comes to help achieve our goals to save the environment. Did you know that 0.6 tons of plastic waste is collected in the ocean annually? Also, more than 70% of collected urban waste is dumped straight into landfills. And thus, a website like the Young Environmentalists will give opportunities for learners to delve deeper into these issues in a fun, interesting, and engaging way. It appears to be a fairly simple step of dumping our waste on a regular basis, reaching landfills that we do not realize the harmful effects of the toxic gases like methane and carbon dioxide released in air. The website created by the Center for Science and Environment team is a one-stop solution which provides us with small and simple ways of managing waste effectively at our homes. The website offers different kinds of learning paths and caters to the needs of every learner. For example, a person interested in owning their creative skills could engage in DIY activities, and a person who is a voracious reader could enjoy the stories. Yet, it connects us all to one common objective, to solve the solution of waste management. The Waste Warrior Dice Roll was very interesting, as it taught me how small daily practices can become a green practice. It also helps to keep my gaming spirit alive, as I was afraid of getting an answer wrong. The compost activity taught me about the things that could be included in a compost and the things that shouldn't be included. An activity sheet such as Why Talk About Waste helps us in organizing the materials available at home and reuse them instead of discarding them. I would love to do more virtual activities like these. The video on making compost from kitchen waste is truly inspiring and encourages me to start my own compost during my summer break with the help of my parents. The website is a wonderful resource for students' research work for their personalized learning pathways. We at Shivnada School explore big ideas and align them with the global context and further connecting them with local solutions. Secondly, during the lockdown, we have observed that the amount of waste generated at homes, making it a perfect time to adapt best practices with the help of our learnings from the website while staying safe at home. Third, often we want to do something for the environment, but we don't know how to go about it, so we end up leaving it. Therefore, this website acts as a guiding tool, sensitizing the young learners like me and spreading awareness as active citizens. I truly enjoyed exploring the website and can't wait to share it with my friends soon. However, I do have a wish list. I love the story of lotus leaves and my wiggly friend in the waste section, as I could relate with every bit of it. Such stories are simple yet impactful to raise awareness about real issues. However, many of us these days do not have the patience to read long texts. Thus, if the stories could also be converted to an audiobook or podcast with expressions and sound effects, it will make the stories more engaging. To conclude my thoughts, I would like to say that after exploring the website, I'm still buzzing with a lot of positive energy to create a better world through simple yet effective means of saving the environment. Thank you for inviting me, and I'm honored to be part of this event. Thank you.
Thank you, Yesha, for being our ambassador and going through the website in such great detail and summarizing it for us. I would now request Ashu ma'am to take over. Ashu ma'am from Shivnada School, Noida.
Thank you, Tushita. Thank you so much, Yesha. I think you've said it all at my end also. Good morning, one and all. Warm greetings to everyone present here and our speakers. I would like to begin by expressing my heartfelt gratitude and congratulate the entire team of Young Environmentalists. You all have put relentless efforts in bringing out the best platform for all of the educators here. And I think this program is going to help many of us in the environment education, because that connects us and then helps the learners to help the educators basically to translate the information into the real life environment. We've often come across the students that wants to be challenged, they want to be questioning, they want to inquire and engage. So, but what better way can be than to, you know, create awareness of issues and create an impactful platform for these young minds. The Young Environmentalist website, I feel, serves every bit of it. It's a unique platform to meet the needs of the learners, cater to the individual learning styles, as mentioned by Yesha. In my opinion, the website has so much to offer to the diverse learning community because it has exciting range of activities. The moment I started engaging in this platform and reviewing it, I really had a quest to do more and more, and I could feel a sense of excitement as well as empowerment. Some of the key features that truly engaged me was and hooked my attention was the upcoming events. So the moment we open the site and we see these upcoming events, announcements, and of course, the digitalization of the Gober Times was truly inspiring because as an educator, I remember 2019 when we all were in the physical space, I used to distribute Gober Times to my friends, my Eco Club students, and they were happy reading it and returning us, after issuing it for a while. Some of the key features that I felt was also the gamified way of learning, DIY activities to enhance their creative skills. Stories, video, poster, comic strips, they will not only sensitize these learners, but also helps them to take responsible actions to find localized solutions, which they can help in their immediate environment. As mentioned by Yesha, we at Shimnada School believes in student agency. We believe that student needs to pave their own path through the personalized learning program. And this website will truly cater to the purpose of research work, exploration, and inquiry-led learning. The activities will help them to explore the big ideas and align with their academic subjects as well. Some of the thought-provoking activities that I felt was food and antibiotics, why talk about LPG, water filters, refrigerator. So these are very simple things that we see often around us, but we don't give much heed to it. And these will help the students to do a self-assessment. They will start recognizing the issues which are pertaining to their immediate environment. I would just like to end here with my last word of appreciation to each and everyone who was involved and recognizing the fact that this website is going to draw great, great attention from all the students, parents, and other stakeholders. Thank you so much, Center for Science and Environment, for giving this opportunity to me to come and speak about it and also sharing with us wonderful collection of all the resources. We truly appreciate your hard work and commitment. Thank you so much. Thank you once again.
Thank you, Ashu ma'am, for taking us through the entire website in 2 minutes. Quite a good job done there. All right. Thank you so much. And before we move to our second last ambassador for the day, I would like to remind everyone that we do have a climate change quiz planned towards the end of this program. So stay on, hear what the students have to speak, and then we will have that quiz at the end and we'll see how many correct answers you get and how aware you are about this problem that we are faced with, climate change. And since Ashu ma'am also mentioned it, when you visit our website on the carousel, you will see all the events that we have planned for you in the future. The nearest is this. We have a biodiversity quiz coming up on June 12th, which is next Saturday. So ensure that you register for it. You see this red button here. Click here to register. You can visit our website, young.downtoearth.org.in. You can click on this button and register yourself for the quiz. We'll have a lot of fun and we will learn while playing the quiz. That's the idea. And then again, next Saturday, we have another event planned for you where we intend to do a storytelling session. Sorit is going to be leading that session. So keep checking this carousel for all the new activities that we have planned for you and stay for the quiz at the end. Moving to our next student ambassador, it is Girishma Goyal from Sriram Centennial School, Indore, Madhya Pradesh. And the school coordinator, B.G. Matthews, ma'am, is also present here. So a big thank you to her as well. Girishma, we would like you to share your assessment of the biodiversity section of the website now.
Okay, thank you, Toshita ma'am.
Yeah.
Biodiversity starts in the distinct past and it points towards the future. Good morning to all the dignitaries, teachers and students present with us. I, Girishma Goyal of grade 10 from Sriram Centennial School, Indore, am honored to address the gathering. The Young Environmentalist is an astounding website. It is an amazing place for us to learn and discover about many issues and concepts regarding environment. And the best part about it is, for example, I'm curious to know about biodiversity and I don't get it by reading it. I could go for other fun and interesting ways like cartoons, DIYs, posters, knowing fun facts and many more, which helps everyone understanding and learning about new things. This method helps even those kids who are not into reading. Instead, they can watch videos, play games, and enhance their knowledge. It is a fascinating way of learning. And I'm sure you all might have heard many biographies, but The Secret Diary of a Virus in the biodiversity section in the website is the best. You all will love to read it. In the biodiversity DIY section, there's many fun ways for protecting the environment, like fishcraft, and there's one called A Home for Little Birds, which require very common materials like jute, thread, scissors, bamboo sticks, metal wire, and a coconut fiber. Even you can take help from Mr. Rakesh Khatriji's video on the website, who makes the same nest. These activities are very easy and handy, are sustainable, and the best kind of gift you would like to give to anyone. Then there's many funny yet educational cartoon comics too, like The Hunter Gets Hunted. We also have various activity sheets and posters, which helps understanding more. Emphasizing on the present scenario, there's lack of oxygen at many places. Earlier, if you remember, there were many people thinking there's no sense in planting trees and saving environment. Whereas now, people are understanding the importance of biodiversity and are trying protecting and preserving it. I myself with my family am practicing many ways to do the same, such as using the method of three-pot composting, making organic pesticide at home. Instead of throwing seeds into litter, we throw them into the forest. I have many medicinal plants at my home and distributed many saplings. We planted plants in the container and drums which are wasted at factories. And like every year, last year also we planted around 52 trees at the common road divider for the benefit of birds, students and passerby. Now, this was all about flora. For fauna also, every day we keep water and grains for the birds and even made nests for them. We also feed milk and chapatis to stray dogs and cows. And I hope these all practices will encourage you all and will help us fighting the pandemic with all the positivity and a beautiful environment. Thank you, and I wish you all a very happy environment day.
Thank you so much, Girishma, for putting it so beautifully. It is indeed the need of the hour. Moving ahead to our last student ambassador, who is Trisha Adya, grade 9 from Delhi Public School, Patna. And we would like to thank Meenakshi ma'am, who's the coordinator of the school, and Sharad Kumar sir and Satya Prakash Gupta sir for all their support. Trisha, I now invite you to go through the section on climate change. If Trisha could be unmuted, please.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, Trisha, please go ahead.
Why is the world the way it is? On the occasion of World Environment Day, I chose to greet you all with this fundamental inquisitiveness that must have lingered in all of us once in a while. Largely, the answer is climate change. But today, it is a concern too. Let me share a few of those concerns. The polar ice sheets are melting. As a result, those beautiful crawling emperor penguins that we see on television are trapped in those melting ice sheets and dying. The flood in the Kazinanga National Park left one horned rhinoceros in between the... If that does not put your concern glass on, then think about it. Ever increasing unpredictable monsoon flooding the cities where you and I are living for years. Is nature claiming its territory back from the Homo sapiens? Are we closing down the chapter of human survival on Earth? If these are little concerns for you, ladies and gentlemen, I take this opportunity to introduce the website of Young Environmentalists under the umbrella of CSE. Perhaps one of the most interesting websites to understand the effects of climate change at your doorsteps. Here, those dream world of Chennai Express bites your tongue with a different name like Chennai Distress, and suddenly you go back to recall the flooded Chennai city few years back due to torrential rain. Read and you know the answers. The famous movie line of all is well, but oil is not well. And I'm sure even Amir Khan will agree to this. Don't you think so? So come and take a dive in this oil spill, with various posters, cartoons. It is refreshing that we don't come across those jargons of science that take us away from the common sense approach of environment concerns. The website carries the idea of greenhouse to eco-friendly laundry. You know, activity sheets are so engaging that you would love to attempt them. The major highlight of this site is the fascinating cartoon strip where the planet story is unfolded in striking way. The slogans are so realistically presented that they make us think as the flag bearers of our nature. And my favorite, bringing sparrows back to our balconies. I loved reading every bit of it. Dear all, if we want answers, we need to learn to generate right questions. And the website is a delight to broaden the horizons about climate change beyond a textbook style. We have always claimed to be the most intelligent creature on this planet Earth. Unfortunately, the way we are dealing with the environment makes us the most foolish species ever born on Earth. Think about it. The website has comic as well as the ideas of Cosmos. It dwells with the campaign, and in the coming days, we may also see live chat with experts. This may fascinate the students to know the things on real-time basis, I feel so. Let's all of us rise up to this occasion to fight climate change and ecological crisis and prove ourselves as the best example of Darwin's survival of the fittest. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Trisha, and thank you all the student ambassadors for assessing our website so well. I mean, as one of the contributors, I know what's there on the website, but after listening to all of you, I have this revived excitement. मुझे पता है सब क्या था, पर आपने इतना अच्छे से बताया कि अब मुझे excitement हो रही है. And I'm sure all my colleagues at CSE who have designed this website and have contributed to it are feeling the same. So thank you so much for doing this, and we hope this encourages all our students present here to take a look at the website and all the different elements of it. I would now want to circle back to Susanna, ma'am. Ma'am, are you there? Is your connection stable now? Susanna, ma'am, from Global Public School. If we could hear you speak.
Hello, can you hear me right now?
Yes, perfect, ma'am.
Please, yeah, thanks. Ahead. Thank you so much, Toshita. Our respected guest, Mr. Rustam Vania, Srishti School of Art and Design and Technology, Ms. Sunita Narayan, Director CSE, the CSE team, fellow teachers and students across India, namaste. I remember reading a deeply poignant book, When Breath Becomes Air, by Dr. Paul Kalanidhi, in which he says, and I quote, life's meaning, its virtue, is something that depends on the relationship that we form. And today, as we connect virtually, fearful and unable to step out of our homes, I realize how shallow the depth of our relationship with nature has become and brought our life to a standstill. Yet, initiatives like the Green School Program, Gobar Times, and particularly this young environmentalist website developed for our students gives me hope. Hope that our children will repair and nurture our environment. For teachers, whatever subject we teach, this initiative is an excellent resource to develop project-based lesson plans and make environment a part and parcel of everything our students learn, be it English, math, science. Environment has to be at the base of it. For a change, instead of just saying, keep the environment clean or go reduce, recycle, we as teachers can find exact action plans and activities to make it happen. The pollution solution game, the greener ride article on transportation, and even the interesting fog catchers of Peru give an amazing insight and awareness of the environment around us. At school, we have a three-pronged approach of awareness, implementation, and monitoring. And across these past years, the resources from the GSP team have helped us learn so, so much. Take a look at the poster on Home Green Home or the environmental cost of fashion, or even the eco-smart launderer. Put them up for discussions in our sessions and see how young minds have the aha effect by themselves. Remember, they are not being taught, they are learning it themselves. One suggestion that I would, if possible, is to have a section on laws that govern the environment. This will help our senior students to learn the framework that already exists in civil society, that it's not just about protest, you know, it's that there is a framework which is not being implemented. So they can work hand in hand well with the governing authorities. Just in closing, Rustam sir, Gobar Times has been a part of my eco journey since 2006, and so has Srishti. My daughter just passed out of there. Thank you, grateful for your influence. Wishing this young environmentalist team the very, very best. And Ms. Sunita Narayan and the entire team at CSE, thank you. You all enrich our lives by teaching us to pause, see, and understand that nature in all its forms wants us to be alive. And we just need to just let it be. Thank you so much, Tushita.
Thank you. Thank you, Susanna, ma'am. Very poignantly put. And thank you, Ashu ma'am, as well for giving us a teacher's viewpoint on the website and telling us how it can be used by teachers as well and not just young environmentalists. Now we will close the program. But before that, I would like to request all of those who are interested in participating in the climate change quiz to stay on after we close the event. It will be open to all. If you are interested, you can stay on for the quiz and play it with us. We have some amazing questions lined up for you that will educate you while we are all having fun. And the idea is to play a game and learn from it. Now, I would request Shukarno to give us his closing comments. And after that, we'll move to the quiz. So over to you, Shukarno.
Thank you, Tushita. Am I audible?
Yes, you are.
So, and these are hardly closing comments. I just want to say that, you know, this is a huge thank you to all of you here. You know, I saw a few people who might have left, but we are really, really grateful that you found the time today to continue with us here today. And I hope you will continue to support and help us nurture this website in future. I just want to, you know, acknowledge the incredible team at CSE and Down to Earth. We have spoken about them a lot through this hour that we spent. I salute and thank them all. Let me just take the names here. Some of them are here with us. Ajit Bajaj, our design head. Akshat Jain, it's an alphabetical order. Akshat Jain, Anubhuti Sharma, Jaydev, Neeraj Kumar, Ranjita Menon, Saroj Sahu, Shorit Gupto, Sukanya Nair, Sushmita Sen Gupta, Tushita Rawat, Vibha Varshne, Yogendra Anand, and many others. And of course, at the head of them, us all, you know, Sunita Ji, Sunita Narayan. Thank you, a very, very big thank you once again to all of you. I now hand over the bit once again to Tushita, our MC of the day. Tushita, over to you.
Thank you so much, Shukarno. And now we officially move to the next and the last section of our program, which is the quiz on climate change. All the students present here, we would encourage you to participate in this quiz. You need not do anything extra for this. We will put it right here on your Zoom screens and you just have to read out the question and then select the answer. Neeraj will tell you more about it. So now I invite Neeraj, my colleague, to conduct the quiz. Neeraj, you're on.
Yeah, thanks a lot, Tushita. So I welcome you all to the last section of today's event, is the climate change quiz. So in which you will see a poll on your screen, Zoom screen, with a question and four options. And you will have 30 seconds to answer each question. So without wasting much time, let's start with the first question on your screen. Just launching the on your screen. Hope you all are able to see. So the first question is, burning of fossil fuels like petroleum and coal release high level of carbon dioxide into the atmosphere and other greenhouse gases. Which of these is not a greenhouse gas? Is it methane, carbon dioxide, hydrogen, or sulfur dioxide? You have 30 seconds. You have 10 more seconds. We'll wait for 10 seconds to over and then we'll show the answer of the particular quiz.
Amazing how the number is increasing, number of responses.
Yeah, I have received 84 responses. And I can see it's going towards the right answer. Most of the people have.
We'll see, but nonetheless, we'll learn something after this quiz, all of us.
Here. Let's. Okay, I'm ending it right now. I've received more than 100 answers. So let's just see the. Okay, so we got the answers and hydrogen is the most like voted answer and is the right answer. So Purna, would you like to tell something about
The question itself, before, you know, as you go on to the next question, let me just quickly add my two bits here. We have talked about methane in this these options. You know, methane has a higher potential to add to global warming, but carbon dioxide is the deadliest of all greenhouse gases, GHGs. Do you know why? Because of its huge quantity. You know, we have huge quantities of carbon dioxide in our atmosphere, and it also has a very, very long shelf life in our atmosphere. Neeraj, can you take on the next question now?
Yeah, so let's move on to the second question. So we had this Tauktae cyclone last month. Which of the following state was not hit by the cyclone Tauktae in May 2021? You have options Kerala, Karnataka, Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra. I think most of you know the answer. You have 15 seconds left. Okay. I think this will be the most...
Vaishnavi looks very happy. I think she knows the answer.
Most of the students are giving the right answer, actually. So I'll just stop it here. I will share the results of this question. So yeah, 67% said the right answer. Great. Madhya Pradesh is the right answer. So I'll just move to the next one while Subhanu can brief us about.
Just let me say a little bit about Madhya Pradesh here. Madhya Pradesh is a landlocked state. That does not mean that it is safe from being affected by climate vagaries. But how does climate change affect such states in India? In MP, for instance, droughts have become more severe and widespread, according to experts. Yeah. And the state is also expected to experience greater numbers of hot days and hot nights, as well as extreme precipitation in the coming years. Now, let's get on to the third one.
Great. Is on your screen. So the world's biggest emitter of greenhouse gas emissions withdraw from 2015 Paris Agreement and joined back in 2021. Which country is it? So is it USA, EU, China, or India? Withdraw in 2015 and then joined back in 2021. So I think this will be the confusing one because it's from the Paris Agreement, 2015 Paris Agreement.
It doesn't look like our young environmentalists are confused, though. They all look very confident.
So the time is over, actually. So let's move to the next question before moving it. Yeah, so great. 45% have said the right answer. It's USA. So at least we got more than around 50% right answers on this confusing question, actually. So let's stop here, the results. Yeah.
Yeah, so, you know, the thing is, the Paris Agreement objective was to prevent an increase in global average temperature levels and keep it well below 2 degrees C. But former President Donald Trump, you know, all of you have heard of him and what he did, believed that the agreement was only beneficial for countries like China and Russia and definitely not for the US. President Biden overturned that decision. So let's get on to question 4.
Question 4, I think this will be the easiest for all of us. Like Greta Thunberg came into the global limelight with a demand for climate action. So we have like, which country does Greta Thunberg belong to, the young environmental activist belong to? So is it Spain, France, Sweden or Finland? Okay, I'm getting right answer for it, this one also. Most of them are, some of them are confused. Okay. So they're saying France, Spain, Finland, Sweden. Okay, you have 5 seconds left. You can answer the question. Okay, I'm ending it right now. So the right answer is Sweden, actually. So around 50% of the audience is given the right answer. Great. 50%, more than 50%. So it's, I think.
Neeraj, could you share the results, please? So that everyone.
Sorry. Yeah, just.
Great. Oh, yeah. Wow.
So 13% saying Spain, 27% France, Sweden 51%, okay, Finland 8%. Yeah.
Now Greta is a Swedish climate change activist, and I think she began in August 2018 with her, you know, days camped out in front of the Swedish Parliament, holding up a sign saying that you know, school strike for climate. So that's Greta. Now let's go on to the fifth question, which is a bit of a trick question.
Yeah, because we have heard about this and we have read in the newspapers and news about UNFCCC, But what is the full form of UNFCCC? Is it United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Culture, United National Framework Convention on Climate Change, United Nations Framework on Convention on Climate Change, or the United Nations Framework Countries on Climate Change? You have 10 seconds left.
Jivika is trying to read the question very carefully. Good job, Jivika. I know you'll give the right answer.
Gautami is still reading the question.
Yeah, please read it very carefully and then choose your
answer. So it is over. I share the result. Yeah, the right answer again, 51% goes to the C option, this United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change. So there's a minor difference between the options, but the right answer, United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change.
Yeah, yes, yes. It came into force in 1994, basically. And it very clearly, you know, defines what is climate change, the various tenets that go with it, etc. So UNFCCC, that's the, and it also is, you know, the organization that is behind the conferences of climate change that happen every year. They have, of course, been withheld for a while because of the COVID pandemic, but they will begin hopefully once again.
So before moving to the sixth question, I'm glad to know that a lot of participants are aware about the climate-related information and they are getting answers more than 50% on each question. Yeah. So with this information, let's move to the next question, which is, what this term often like extreme weather events. So what does extreme weather events mean to you? An event that is rare for that time of the year, the event has a higher intensity than expected, or an event that is different from the normal weather patterns, or if, we can say all of the above are the answer. All these three means extreme weather events. You have 10 seconds. We have got more than 100 answers already. Mm-hmm. Okay. So let's stop it here. So yeah, all of the above. 77% participants are saying all these three means to the extreme weather events. Yeah.
Right. Yeah, so yeah, that's great actually, you know, the percentage of people. Now, one of the things that I want people to remember here is a very, very, significant data point that we also talked about when yesterday we released our new publication on State of India's Environment. Extreme weather events are one of the biggest reasons today for internal displacement and migration of people across the world. You know, we keep talking about migration of people. These extreme weather events, they are more, you know, far more potent than civil war, for instance. So let's get on to the seventh one with that.
Yeah. So like we have different agencies in our country to work in the environmental sector, environment departments with different government and central government and state government. So which principal agency is responsible for weather forecasting, observation and seismology, and keeps the record of changing weather events and patterns across India, across country? So is it Environmental Information System, ANVIS, or India Meteorological Department, CPCB, Central Pollution Control Board, or Flood Forest Information by Central Water Commission? Which one of these is the agent, principal agency for weather forecasting? And all these like things mentioned on my screen, keeps the record of changing weather events and patterns. Can we have the answers? Okay. And I think let's send. I'll share the results with all of you. It is India Meteorological Department, which keeps the record of changing weather events and pattern, and also weather forecasting, observation, and seismology. So it is the right answer.
Yeah, it's a agency of the Ministry of Earth Sciences of the Government of India, basically.
Yeah.
So okay. So now the eighth question, Neeraj.
Yeah, I'm launching it right now. So last year, okay, is it visible to a screen?
Yes.
Give us a thumbs up if you can see it. No. Okay, Viraj is saying no.
Yeah, yeah. I think because I can't see the timer, so I'll relaunch this poll.
Yes.
Okay.
All right, noted. We're relaunching it.
I hope you're not able to, you are able to see this.
Visible now.
Yeah.
Visible, right? Okay, great.
So last year, India suffered with the biggest locust attack in 25 years, and different reasons can be attested it, but what do you think is the reason for the increase in the attacks in recent years, and especially the last year, the biggest in last 25 years? So is it frequent cyclone, due to frequent cyclone, earthquake is the reason, snowfall is the reason, or volcano eruption? Which one is the right answer? I have 106 answers already. Okay, and we have 5 seconds left. So that we can have more than 130 people have answered. So I'll just stand it here. As is, the right answer is frequent cyclone. And we have, yeah, most of the people have answered the right option.
That's great, actually. But, you know, let me just butt in here and just make that connection. Basically, what we have found is locust attacks, though they have been a common occurrence for many, many years, now their intensity and frequency and their scale is increasing. And climate change is one of the reasons, say experts. The frequent and intense cyclones lead to heavy rains in the desert.
Yeah.
And locusts multiply faster in such conditions. So that is the reason. Over to you, Neeraj.
Thank you. With the students, and I'll just move to the second last question of this event is, how should India respond to climate risk? We have young environmentalists with us. So what do you think is, I'll just launch this quiz. It's on your screen. How should India respond to climate risk? All of you are there to answer our question, like better forecasting. Do we need better forecasting? We need to build climate resilient infrastructure, or we need to provide livelihood to the most vulnerable. And the last option in all of the above. So, okay, you have 10 seconds. Most of you have already answered, 140 plus participants, 150 around. So, okay. So this is like encouraging, very encouraging that I show the results to you so that you can make it.
Wow.
Yeah, like all of the above. Okay. All of our young environmentalists are saying we need to do all these things. Better forecasting. Yeah. Yes,
and they're right, Neeraj. I mean, because basically India is one of the world's 10 most affected countries due to climate change.
Yeah.
And, while we have made some progress in terms of our commitments, but there is still a huge amount of ground that needs to be covered.
But we are thrilled that like most of you understand this, and all of you, almost all of you have given, 132 people give the right answer, and we need these things to be done in nearest future.
Absolutely.
So I'll stop here, and I'll see, it comes to the last piece of this section, and it's related to renewable energy.
Right.
And
get ready, guys. Last question of the quiz. Let's all of us do it.
Yes. So what is India's target for installed renewable energy capacity by 2022? Is it 175 gigawatt? Is it a trick question? I would say it's a fact-based question. So we might get different opinion on it. Mm-hmm. And you might get different answers on it because it's related to facts. But we need to be careful about the facts also regarding the informations and all. What are our targets for future, and what are our renewable energy targets or other targets which we are planning to do? So we have 5 seconds left. We'll see the answer. I'll amend it right now and I'll share results with you. So I think this is a single question where we less than the rock answer. So the target is 175 gigawatt actually.
Correct. The target is 175 gigawatt of renewable energy capacity by the year 2022. लेकिन क्या हम इस टारगेट को मीट कर रहे हैं ये थोड़ा डाउटफुल है सीएससीज न्यू डेटा यू नो पॉइंट्स टू द फैक्ट दैट वी हैव ओनली मैनेज्ड टिल नाउ टू मीट 55% ऑफ द टारगेट सो 2022 जो कि अगले साल है उस समय तक बाकी मीट कर पाना हमें नहीं लगता ये पॉसिबल होगा
एग्जैक्टली सो
ओवर टू यू नीरज
Yeah. So I think it was a great experience for all of us, and I hope you all enjoyed the quiz and it made you curious to know more about climate change and climate related information. And I hope YE website will definitely help you. And obviously, and then the last question which we had to correct your information regarding the facts and the other climate related information that we have on our website. So all the best, and again, I'll just wish you a happy World Environment Day again. Over to you, Tushita.
Thank you, Neeraj, for that quiz. I can see so many of you giggling in your screens. I hope you got all your answers right. Okay, is there anyone who got all 10 answers right? Give me a thumbs up if you got all 10 correct. No, okay. Galat ho gaya.
We have Sashank Vidhan with us. Sashank Vidhan is saying he got all the
ideas. Oh, great. Congratulations.
Lakshya Kumar is also there.
Okay, Man is saying he got 8 right. 8 yeah. is also a good number. Tanvi got all 10 correct.
Sai Maitreya, Gayatri Taneja. We have few students.
I mean, it's great if you got all 10 correct, but that was not the idea of this quiz. I mean, great, but the idea was to learn, and I'm sure all of you did that. I will now invite my colleagues at CSE if any of them wants to add anything before we close. Anubhuti, Ranjita, Shuparno, anybody?
Maybe Ranjita.
Yeah.
Ranjita is there.
You'd like to hear
you're on mute. Yeah.
Okay. Great. Thank you. Thank you so much. This event was well done. Yeah. And I wish everyone the best.
Thank you so much. All right. So with this, we close our event. Sunita ma'am, anything from you before we close?
Just to say thank you so much. I mean, aap logon ne, you know, ye jo questions the, main bhi nahi jaanti thi inke answers. To mujhe lagta hai thoda zyada hi mushkil questions puche Tushita aur Neeraj ne. Thoda sa simple karke rakhiyega. Magar yahi hai, jab tak hum log facts nahi janenge, jab tak hum thodi gehrai se cheezon ko nahi samjhenge, waise चीजें बदलेंगी भी नहीं और बदलनी तो है. हमें बहुत कुछ काम करना है, बहुत कुछ आगे जाके चीजें बदलनी है. और बदलने की जो ताकत है वो हम में ही है, सब में है, हमारे दिमाग में है, हमारे हाथों में है और साथ काम करने में है. सबसे बड़ी जो ताकत है वो यही है कि हम लोग साथ मिलके काम करें और उससे चीजें बदलेंगी, बहुत बदलेंगी. मुझे लगता है जो मैंने आज एनर्जी देखी सबके अंदर, जो मैंने एक ऐसा ये भी देखा कि आप लोग, इट्स नॉट जस्ट एनर्जी, आप लोगों में डिटर्मिनेशन कि बदलेगा, एक जुनून है, एक 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 क्लियर इंटेंशन है कि आप करके रहेंगे. ये बहुत जरूरी है, हम सबके लिए बहुत जरूरी है. हम सब अपने आप को वॉरियर्स मानते हैं, आप सब वॉरियर्स हैं, आप इन्वायरमेंटलिस्ट हैं, यंग इन्वायरमेंटलिस्ट हैं, हम ओल्ड इन्वायरमेंटलिस्ट हैं, मगर सब जो काम है वो जो भी कदम हम लोग सब साथ लेंगे उसी से चीजें बदलेंगी. रुस्तम, कुछ जोड़ना चाहोगे इस पे? रुस्तम सा ऑन म्यूट, एक मिनट. हाँ,
some master controller somewhere.
No, I think we should unmute everybody after Rustam speaks.
I remember when Gobert Times was launched, it was in IHC, and Kiran Bedi had come, was our chief guest, and it was a great, delightful, fun event.
Yeah.
And it's so nice to see, you know, and those kids, I don't know how old they will be, of the age group which I see over here, who are 8 or 9 or something. And there was, that hall was full of such young kids that day. It's so nice to see that there's a continuation of all that work which was started then. Now there are even more people. I think the numbers are much larger. Mm. And that is so heartening to see. So I just want to wish CSE and all the young people who are here the very best for the future.
Thank you so much, Sunita ma'am and Rustam sir, for closing with that thought and leaving that thought for us to think about. In the comment section, in the chat section, we have put the website URL and also the link to the quiz, which will be held on 12 June, which is next Saturday. Please check it out. Please register for it. The registration process is very simple. It's on Zoom. So fill out some basic details and then you will get to participate in the quiz. Check out all the sections on the website and keep learning. Be relevant, be impactful, and keep doing what you're doing. So Sukanya, if you could unmute all our friends here, we'll give a big round of applause to everyone who came here and shared their thoughts with us. And we'll get to say bye to everyone. Can we do that once? All right, we'll now be unmuting all of you. Just a second.
Let me try that thing.
Yes, this shout out is very important. So all the young environmentalists, thank you too. Thank you for being here and give a big shout out.
Thank you, ma'am.
It was a wonderful experience speaking
to us
in front of so much people. And I like this. Well, thank you once again for providing this opportunity.
Thanks, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you so much. Thank you for attending. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, all our student ambassadors.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, Tushita ji.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Tushita ji.
Thank you for joining us, ma'am.
Thank you.
Can we leave, madam? Can we leave?
Yes, yes.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Tushita ma'am.
Thank you,
Tushita
ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, Tushita ma'am.
Thank you for joining us, Charu ma'am. Thank you for
all
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you,
Tushita
ma'am.
Thank you so much.
Vishwa Paryavaran Dimash, aap sabhi ko hardik shubhkamnaye.
बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया सर
थैंक यू नीरज सर
थैंक्स थैंक्स टू यू आल्सो
ऑल राइट वी विल नाउ बी एंडिंग द मीटिंग सो सी यू ऑल नेक्स्ट सैटरडे इन द बायोडाइवर्सिटी क्विज बाय बाय टेक केयर टिल देन एंड डू चेक आउट द वेबसाइट